The first Red Scare was a fear that Eastern Europeans and Russians, or at the time known as Soviets, were going to overthrow the U.S. government. It all started with the Bolshevik Revolution in Russia in 1917, when the Romanov dynasty ended and imperial rule in Russia was no longer. This revolution was a socialist revolution led by Vladimir Lenin. The revolution took place during the final phase of World War I, when Russia got taken out of the war, and it brought about the transformation of the Russia Empire into the Soviet Union of Soviet and Socialist Republics.
In 1908, the Department of Justice hired 10 former Secret Service agents to join an expanded office 2 years after the formation of this group. It had gained over 300 people. This organization became known as the Bureau of Investigation. It originally used to investigate criminals who crossed state lines. However, during World War I in 1917, it was given the responsibility of investigating draft dodgers, violators of the Espionage Act, and immigrants suspected of radical communism. J. Edgar Hoover became a powerful figure in the Bureau and worked alongside Attorney General Palmer during the Palmer raids.
On June 15, 1917, the U.S. Congress passed the Espionage Act. This prohibited obtaining information, recording pictures, or copying any information related to national defense with the intent to be used against the U.S. or to aid another foreign nation. It also penalized anyone who would cause disloyalty or insubordination among the American military or naval powers, resulting in a $10,000 fine and 20 years in prison.
On October 16, 1918, Congress passed the Immigration Act of 1918 in order to give the government the ability to deport unacceptable foreigners such as people who were communists, anarchists, labor organizers, and activists.
In 1918, the Sedition Acts were passed in an attempt to expand the Espionage Act. These set of laws made it illegal to say or write anything disloyal, profane, or abusive towards or against the United States government, further constricting free speech. Capital punishment consisted of 5 to 20 years in a federal prison.
In 1919, anarchist named Luigi Galliani began mailing a series of more than 30 bombs targeted towards high-level politicians, judges, and law enforcement officials. Those who had received the bombs were in support of different radical or nativist ideals.
The first bomb to explode was sent in April of 1919 to Thomas Hardwick, a former U.S. senator and supporter of the Immigration Act. Hardwick and his wife managed to survive the bombing. However, his wife, Maud Perkins, was hospitalized with severe injuries and their maid lost her hands.
On June 2, 1919, Galliani's followers, also known as Gallianists, managed to detonate 8 bombs simultaneously in 8 different cities. The bombs were addressed to politicians who had endorsed anti-immigrant acts, sedition acts, and encouraged mass deportation. Judges who sentenced other anarchists to prison were also targeted by the bombs. None of the targeted men were killed. However, one bomb killed a New York watchman and another detonated prematurely, killing a pro-Gallianist newspaper editor.
The government was enraged by the bombings and responded by having the U.S. Department of Justice conduct a sequence of raids, arresting potential communists, foreign anarchists, and radical leftists. Those that were raided and caught were either deported or got arrested and served a severe sentence.
In December of 1919, the U.S. Department of Justice rounded up 249 suspected anarchists into the BFOD, also known as the Soviet Ark. These non-citizens were deported to Russia, with 199 of them having been detained in Palmer raids. While many moderate people were on board, there were 2 famous anarchists on board as well. This sparked the American press to celebrate the deportation of the Russian Reds and call for more similar deportation. Nicola Sacco and Bartolomeo Vanzetti were 2 Italian migrant anarchists who were controversially convicted of murdering a guard and a paymaster during the April 15, 1920, armed robbery of the Slater and Morrow Shoe Company in Bartree, Massachusetts. Millions of people felt that they were both innocent and didn't receive a fair trial in the process due to having incompetent lawyers and being convicted after the trial even began. FBI, the first wave of these raids were widely accepted among the American citizens. However, after the second wave in 1920, Alexander Palmer was faced with much criticism due to the brutal nature of these raids coming into the light, leading to the creation of the American Civil Liberties Union, or ACLU, whose first mission was to challenge the Sedition Act.
On September 16, 1920, a horse-drawn cart pulled up across the street from the J.P. Morgan Bank, the busiest corner of Wall Street. The driver quickly fled from the cart before it exploded, immediately killing around 30 people and injuring over 300. The perpetrator was never caught, but a series of letters sent the very next day suggested the Galleonists were to blame.
After the Wall Street bombings, the U.S. was still on edge, and the American public took matters onto their own hands. As a result, the New York State Legislature expelled 5 socialist representatives from their ranks, and 12 radicals were arrested, and some got beaten to death. 28 states banned the public display of red flags. Later on, though, some Americans began to speak out and demanded that American civil liberties be respected. In the summer of 1920, the situation got less intense.